Good morning, students. I hope everybody is fine and healthy at home. So, in the last session, we have completed the fifth chapter, that was the apricot tree. There we have seen a story of a small boy. He was narrating his own story that how he and his family, they saved themselves from the bombardment. And they had to leave their place and they had to stay in a camp. Okay, so that lesson we have studied, named as the apricot tree, in the previous session. And its question answer exercises, word meaning, that is already uploaded in the website. I had already told to copy it down from the website, and I wish and I hope that you people have copied it and written in the copy. And I also hope that you people are learning all these question answers, word meaning and exercises, whatever is given. Because all these chapters, whatever is taught, that will come in the first semester. So keep on learning whatever is taught. Okay. So today we will start the next chapter, sixth chapter, that is Annie of Green Gables. Okay. And this chapter, lesson 6, that is the last chapter for the first semester. That means there are 6 lessons will be coming in the first semester. Okay, so this will be the last chapter for the first semester. And in the first semester, I have already told, there are 2 poems. Okay, that is the first one, A Ballad of Mystic Memories, and the Kayak. Okay, so the Kayak poem you have to learn by heart. Okay, first poem you have to only learn word meaning and question answer. Okay, and the Kayak poem, that will come for writing also. Okay, so now we'll start the sixth chapter, that is Annie of Green Gables. Okay, this story is also extract. This story is also, it's an extract taken from a novel. Extract, I have already told what is the meaning of extract. Extract means a small part, okay, a small part taken from a novel, drama, essay, or from somewhere. Okay, so this is also an extract from the novel. Okay, the novel name is also Annie of Green Gables. Okay, this novel is written by Little Lucy Maud Montgomery. Okay, Little Lucy Maud Montgomery, and this author is a Canadian author. And she is famous as her name is written in the books and novels, that is L.M. Montgomery, okay, short form Little Lucy, that is written as L.M. Montgomery in most of her novels. And this Canadian author, she was mostly famous for this novel only, that is Annie of Green Gables. Okay, so here in this lesson, we will see that how a person can make simple things in a beautiful way. Means here we'll see that a small girl, and you can guess what is her name. That name of the girl is, that is Annie. Okay, so through her imagination she changes the simple things also in a very beautiful manner. Okay, she sees everything through her imagination, and she enjoys the simple thing also. Okay, so here we see that how the small girl, she enjoys her journey from the station to a new place. That place name is Green Gables. Okay, here we see that Mr. Martin, okay, that is there is a person name, sorry, not Martin, Matthew. Okay, the person name is Matthew Cuthbert, and his sister, okay, they were about to adopt an orphan boy. Okay, they were expecting to adopt an orphan boy, but in the place of a boy, a girl comes to the station to be admitted in to be adopted by Matthew Cuthbert. Okay, so in the beginning, the man was little disappointed. He was not happy to see a girl, because he wanted a boy to be adopted. He wanted a boy to adopt. But in the place of a boy, a small girl comes there. And in the beginning, he was little hesitant to take him, to take the girl. But when he saw the girl is very friendly, fun-loving, and she was very excited to go to the new place, Green Gables. Seeing that, the man thought that he would take the little girl to his place. Okay, so all through the journey, the girl continuously she was talking. The man was very calm, Matthew was calm, and he was only listening, and he was enjoying the girl talking. Okay, so that is the lesson about. Okay, so now we will read the lesson. If you have got your book, I hope everybody must have got the book, so you can take out your book, and the page number is 45, lesson 6, Annie of Green Gables. Okay, so now I will switch on to the screen. Okay, so you can see on the screen, that is the 6th chapter, that is Annie of Green Gables. Okay, before we start the lesson, there are pictures given here. You can see in your book or here on the screen. Here three pictures are there, given there. Okay, so while seeing the first picture, can you guess what is this? What do you imagine? Either you can see there is a dog, you can see there is a dog, or two cats are there. Okay, some of you can see here there is a dog. Okay, there is a dog, this is mouth and these are the ears, and some of you may imagine these are two cats. Okay, now see the next picture. Some of you may imagine that there is a girl looking towards this side, but if you see carefully, you will find there is a sheep also. Okay, sheep mouth is this, it's looking down. Okay, okay, now see the third picture. Here you can see that a man with a big nose, this is the mouth, this is eyes, a man, these are the hair, a man's face is given. But some of you may see there is a picture of a snowman also. Okay, from the back. Okay, this is the head and these are the hand, this is the hand, this is another hand. Okay, this is the body, these are legs. Okay, so that means the way you see something, you can imagine and you can see different things. So that means everybody's imagination is different. Okay, so now here we'll see that the lesson is also based on imagination. Now let us read an extract from a novel set in Canada about a poor orphan girl, Annie, who comes to live with an old man and his sister. They were expecting to adopt a boy but land up with Annie instead. Read how the man reacts to her and how she makes ordinary things seem beautiful by using her imagination. Okay, so here you have seen a little introduction about it, that it's a story about a girl. The girl's name is Annie. And she is coming from some other place to live with an old man and his sister. And this man, this old man and his sister, they were expecting a boy. They were expecting to adopt a boy. But when they reached the place to receive the boy, they found there was a girl. So here we'll see in the story that how this man reacts on seeing a girl in the place of a boy, and how this girl, she makes ordinary things, simple things, makes beautiful by using her imagination. Okay, now we'll read the lesson. Matthew Cuthbert and the sorrel mare jogged comfortably over the 8 miles to Bright River. When he reached Bright River station, the long platform was almost deserted. The only living creature inside being a girl who was sitting on a pile of shingles at the extreme end. Matthew encountered the station master and asked him if the 5:30 train would soon be along. Okay, so the old man, his full name is Matthew Cuthbert, and the sorrel mare. What is sorrel means? Sorrel meaning is given here. That means a light reddish brown horse. Okay, it's the color of the horse. Okay, mare means a male horse. Okay. So he was riding in a buggy. Buggy, you know what is buggy? Buggy is a cart pulled by the horse. Okay, so they were moving on a vehicle that was pulled by a horse comfortably over the 8 miles to Bright River. Okay, so from where he was coming, the station to the place. The place name is Bright River. Bright River is the name of a place. He was coming, covering the distance, and the distance was 8 miles from his home. And when he reached the station, Bright River station, when he reached the station, he saw the platform was almost deserted. Deserted means, what is the meaning of deserted? I have told in the last lesson also, that was, it means no people with, okay? There were no people on the platform. It was all empty. And only one living creature, means only one human being was seen there. That was a girl. And where she was sitting on a pile of shingles. Shingles means small round stones, okay? Small stones were piled up on the platform, and she was sitting above that, okay, at the extreme end. Okay, that means at the end of the far end of the station. Matthew encountered means met. Okay, then the man, he met the station master and asked him if the 5:30 train would soon be along. So then he asked the station master if the 5:30 train, means the train which is arriving at 5:30, that would come soon or not. It would be coming. He asked that whether it would be coming or not. Okay, I forgot to show the picture of L.M. Montgomery. Okay, she is the author of the novel Annie of Green Gables. Okay, L.M. Montgomery. The 5:30 train has been in and gone half an hour ago, answered that brisk official. But there was a passenger dropped off for you, a little girl. She's sitting out there on the shingles. Then the station master told that the 5:30 train, the train which will arrive at 5:30, that has been already arrived. Has been in means already arrived, and before half an hour it had already gone. Okay, it was before time, it has reached there and it has already moved to the next destination. And then the station master he answered it, and then he said, he added that there was a passenger, that from the train there was a passenger came down for you. For you means for Mr. Matthew Cuthbert. A passenger came down and he said that was a little girl, and the girl is sitting there on the shingles. He pointed towards the round small stones and he said that the girl is sitting there. She only got down from the train and this girl is for him only. I'm not expecting a girl, said Matthew blankly. It's a boy I have come for. He should be here. Mrs. Alexander Spencer was to bring him over from Nova Scotia for me. And Matthew was very much surprised. He was blank, means he was so surprised. And he said, because he came there to adopt a girl or boy. He came there to adopt a boy. So he says that he was so surprised, and he's saying that I'm not expecting a girl. He says that he did not come there to take a girl. And he says that he has come there to receive a boy. And he says that he should be here, means maybe he will be coming. And Mrs. Alexander Spencer, and he also told that Mrs. Alexander Spencer, she was bringing that boy from where? From Nova Scotia. Okay, for me. Nova Scotia, it's the name of a place. From there, she must be bringing that boy for him. Guess there's some mistake, he said. Mrs. Spencer came off the train with that girl and gave her into my charge. Said you and your sister were adopting her from an orphan asylum, that you would be along for her presently. Okay. Then the station master said that he's making, that means he guessed that Matthew is making some mistake, because Mrs. Spencer only came by train. She was there in the train and she only brought this girl, and she had handed over this girl to him by saying that he will come, that Mr. Matthew Cuthbert, he will come, he and along with his sister, he will come and they will adopt that girl from an orphan asylum. Asylum means, what is the meaning of asylum? Asylum means an institution to take care of people. Okay, it means an institution that takes care of the people. Okay, so he said that the lady, Mrs. Spencer, she only came by train, and that girl is brought by Mrs. Spencer only, and she handed over the girl to the station master and saying that Mr. Matthew and his sister, they were adopting, means they were adopting her, means they will be adopting this girl from the orphan asylum, and that you would be along for her presently. And presently means, that means very soon, that means here that very soon you both will come here and you will receive this girl. Matthew groaned as he turned about and shuffled gently down the platform towards her. What is the meaning of groaned? Yes, groan means make a deep sound of conveying despair. Means he was not happy to listen that. Means he made some noise that shows that he was disappointed. As he turned about, when he turned to see that girl, he made a sound of that he was not happy and shuffled gently down the platform towards her. And then he started going down the platform because the girl was sitting at the end of the platform. He started walking towards her. She had been watching him ever since he had passed her, and she had her eyes on him now. And the girl who was sitting there, when Matthew came there, from that time, this small girl, she is watching this man. She is watching Matthew only. And now also she had her eyes, means he was looking at him only. A child of about 11, grabbed in a very short, very tight, very ugly dress of yellowish grey wincey. She wore a faded brown sailor hat, and beneath the hat, extending down her back, were two braids of very thick, decidedly red hair. Her face was small, white and thin, also much freckled. Her mouth was large and so were her eyes, which looked green in some lights and moods and grey in others. Okay. So now when he looked at the girl, he found that the girl was, she was about 11 years old, and she was garbed in a, garbed means, what is the meaning of garbed? Garb means dressed. She was wearing a very short, very tight, very ugly dress. Means the, it looked like the girl was wearing that dress from many years. The girl has grown, but the dress was, dress has become very short and tight for her. It was very ugly, not washed from many days. It was yellowish gray wincey. What is wincey? Wincey means here a strong, lightweight fabric made of a mixture of wool and cotton. Okay, it's a strong, lightweight fabric made up of mixture of wool and cotton, a kind of fabric only. Okay, so the dress was made up of wincey. and she wore a faded brown sailor hat. She was wearing a faded hat. Faded means the color has gone. Means when you buy some thing in the beginning, the color of the thing will be very bright, but after using it several times, the color becomes dull. Okay, so same way the girl was wearing a sailor hat that has become very dull in the color, brown color. And beneath the hat, he could see that her hair was very long, extending down her back. From the back, it was very long and it was made into braids, very thick braids of very thick. You know what is the meaning of braids? Braids means the to tie the hair in a certain plaits. Okay, I'll show you the picture also. Girls, they used to make in the school also, you must have seen the girls, they make their hairstyle like this. This is known as braid, tying in a style, this style, this is known as braids. Okay, okay, these are braids. Okay, okay, so the girl has long hair, they were tied in two braids, very thick braids, and decidedly red hair, and the color of the hair was red. Her face was very small, she was very fair and very thin, and also much freckled. Freckle means covered with small patches of light brown color on the skin. Means she doesn't take care of her skin properly, so there were patches of light brown color on her face. Her mouth was large and so were her eyes, and her mouth were very big, same way her eyes were also very big. Okay, she has big eyes, big lips, which looked green in some light, and sometime when the light was falling on her eyes, it was looking green color, and so time it was looking gray color. Okay, so that was the description of the small girl. Okay, she stood up, grasping with one thin brown hand the handle of a shabby old fashioned carpet bag. The other she held out to him. She stood up. Now the girl, when she saw the man was coming towards her only, she stood up from the shingles and grasping with one thin brown hand the handle of a shabby old-fashioned carpet bag. Grasping means you know very well, that is holding or to grab something. Okay, to hold on something. So she took hold of a brown bag. She had a brown color handled bag of a shabby. Shabby means not clean, dirty. Okay, dirty bag. Very old fashioned carpet bag it was, and the other hand she held out to him. And so with one hand she grabbed her dirty brown bag, and the other hand she held out to him, and she stretched out her hand so that the man would help her in getting up from there. Okay. I suppose you are Mr. Matthew Cuthbert of Green Gables, she said in a peculiarly clear, sweet voice. I am very glad to see you. I was beginning to be afraid you weren't coming for me, and I was imagining all the things that might have happened to prevent you. I had made up my mind that if you didn't come for me tonight, I would go down the track to that big wild cherry tree at the bend and climb up into it to stay all night. I wouldn't be a bit afraid, and it would be lovely to sleep in a wild cherry tree, all white with bloom in the moonshine. Don't you think? You could imagine you were dwelling in marble halls, couldn't you? And I was quite sure you would come for me in the morning if you didn't tonight. Okay, now Matthew Cuthbert, he was very much surprised. He was not happy also to see a girl, because he was expecting a boy instead of a girl. But this girl, Matthew didn't say anything seeing the girl, but this small girl, she did not hesitate a bit also, and she started speaking. Can you imagine if you meet a person, you are a small boy or girl and you are meeting a person for the first time. I think you won't speak much. But this little girl, she started speaking by her own only. Okay, so she is only asking to the man, I suppose you are Mr. Matthew Cuthbert of Green Gables. So she is only asking that, she was guessing that he is only Matthew Cuthbert from Green Gables, to whom she was expecting to come and take from there. She said in a peculiarly clear, peculiarly means strangely, okay, means in a very strange, clear, sweet voice, but her voice was very sweet. And then she continued speaking. She says that she was very happy to see him. Now you can see that how this small girl, she is continuously speaking. And she says that she is very happy to see him there. And because it was very late and she was waiting there, and she thought that she was little afraid. She had a doubt also that he won't come. You weren't coming for me. And means she had already started. She was afraid also that if he is not coming, then what would have happened with him? Means she started imagining, because he was late, so she started imagining that why Mr. Matthew is not coming, means all the things that had happened to prevent you, means I was imagining all the things that might have happened to prevent you. She was waiting there for Matthew Cuthbert, and when he was little late, because half an hour before only her train arrived there and she was waiting there. So he was waiting and she started imagining that Mr. Matthew is not coming, then what could be the reason? She started imagining what could be the reason behind them that he is late. I mean, she only started imagining. I had made up my mind, and she had already decided. Made up my mind means she had already decided that if he didn't come, if he is not coming to take her that night, tonight means that night, if he is not coming to take her that night, what she will do? She will go down the track. She will go down through the track, and there was a big wild cherry tree at the bend, at the corner. There was a big wild cherry tree, and she would climb up on the tree to stay there for the whole night. Can you imagine? Can you do like this? If suppose you are waiting at the station for your parents or some relatives, and you are new to that place and nobody comes there, what you will do? I don't think anybody would think like this, to climb a cherry tree and stay all the night. Many of you would start crying also. But this little girl, very frankly, she was talking to Mr. Matthew Cuthbert, and she was saying that she had already started what could be the reason why he is coming late, why he is not coming till now. And she had already decided, she had made up her mind that she had already decided that if Mr. Matthew is not coming there, she would go down to the track, and there is a big wild cherry tree. She would climb there and she would sleep there for the night. I wouldn't be a bit afraid, and it would be lovely to sleep in a wild cherry tree all white with bloom in the moonshine, don't you think? And then she is saying that she won't be afraid. She will not be afraid of anything. A little bit also, she won't be afraid of anything, because it would be lovely to sleep. Means she is saying that it is so nice, it would be so interesting to sleep in a wild cherry tree, because the tree had lots of bloom. Bloom means, what is the meaning of bloom? Bloom means flower. Okay, the cherry tree had white flowers and they were shining in the moonshine, don't you think? So she is asking that how would you do when you be in this kind of situation. You could imagine you were dwelling in marble halls and sleeping on the cherry tree. You can imagine that you are dwelling. Dwelling means, what is the meaning of dwelling? Dwelling means living. You can imagine that you are living in a marble hall. Marble, you know, marble, it's a kind of stone or rock that is in which color? White color. Okay. So she's, now here you can see, she is talking about a white cherry tree that is covered with white flowers, and she is imagining that she would be sleeping in a hall that is made up of marble, white marble. And I was quite sure you would come for me in the morning. And then she again, she says that she was very much sure. She was very sure that Mr. Matthew would definitely come in the morning if he is not coming tonight. If he is not coming in the night, definitely he would come, be coming the next morning. Matthew had taken the scrawny little hand awkwardly in his then, and there he decided he would take her home. Now, Matthew, he took the little hand because the girl had extended her hand. Then Matthew also, he took hold of her hand, scrawny. Scrawny means very thin, okay? So, very thin little hand, he awkwardly means he was little hesitant. He was, because he was not expecting a girl, he was expecting a boy. So, he was not very happy, but then also he took hold of her hand, and then he decided he would take her home because the man, he liked the way the girl was speaking. So, he decided that he will take the little girl to to his home. Not another word did she say until they had left the village and were driving down a steep little hill. The child put out her hand and broke off a branch of wild plum that brushed against the side of the buggy. Okay, now they started, the girl sat down in the buggy and they started moving to the place where they were going. They were going to Green Gables. Okay, so not another word. So she started going. Now she did not say anything till they had left the village. Till they started moving, she did not say anything. And they were driving down a steep little hill. They were crossing through a steep hill. Okay, there were mountains both sides of the road. And the child, she had taken out her hand and then she broke off a branch of wild plum. Okay, plum, it's a kind of fruit. There were plum trees on the side of the road. So she took out her hand of the window of the buggy and then she plucked off a branch of the plum tree that brushed against the side of the buggy. That was brushing against the side of the buggy, means it was touching the buggy. There were plants and shrubs, were they were touching the buggy. So she had taken her hand out and then she broke off a small branch of a white plum. Out from the bank, all white and lacy, make you think of, she asked. Now she saw another tree. That tree was covered with white flowers and they were looking like just like a lace. So she is asking to Matthew Cuthbert that, isn't it that tree is very beautiful? And see that tree, how does that tree look like to him? She is asking, if you see that tree is covered with white flower that is bending towards the bank. Bank means the side, okay, at the side of the road the tree is bending. And is asking, how does that tree which is full covered with white flowers, how does it look like? Well, now I don't know, said Matthew. Okay, then Matthew, he's saying that he doesn't know. Don't know means don't know. Okay, that is the short form of don't know. Okay, so Matthew Cuthbert, he is saying that he doesn't know how does the tree is looking like to her. Then she says, why, a bride, of course, a bride all in white with a lovely misty veil. I have never seen one. but I can imagine what she would look like. I don't ever expect to be a bride myself. I am so homely, nobody will ever want to marry me, unless it might be a foreign missionary. Oh, there are a lot more cherry trees all in bloom. This island is the bloomiest place. I just love it already, and I am so glad I am going to live here. Okay. So the girl pointed towards a tree that was all covered with white flowers, and she asked to Matthew Cuthbert that how does that tree is looking to him? How does it look like? Then Matthew replied that he doesn't know that how it is looking. Then she saying, why a bride? Of course, a bride all in white with a lovely misty veil. Then the girl is saying, isn't it that tree is looking like a bride? Bride, you know what is bride? Bride means dulhan, okay? Bride, okay? And you know that in Christian community, people, when they get married, the bride, she wears a white dress, okay, white gown, okay. So the girl is saying that the tree, isn't it looking like a bride? And the bride is wearing a beautiful white color dress, okay, misty veil. Veil, you know what is the meaning of veil? V-E-I-L. Okay, veil is a very thin covering used on the head, okay, veil. That is, in Hindi you can say odni, okay, a covering, very thin fine cloth used as covering for the head, okay. So the girl is saying, isn't it that tree is looking like a bride, and the bride is wearing a very beautiful white dress, and her head is covered with a white veil. And then she says that though she had never seen any bride, she says, I have never seen one. One means she had never seen any bride in her life, but she can imagine that how does she look, that how a bride looks like. She can imagine. I don't ever expect to be a bride myself. And then she continues saying that, she says that she never wanted to be a bride in her life. She never wanted to get married. That means she wanted to say that she doesn't want to get married. She doesn't want to become a bride because I am so homely, nobody will ever want to marry me unless it might be a foreign missionary. And she says that because she is homely. Homely means, what does mean homely? Homely means here ordinary looking. She says that she doesn't want to marry in her life because she is very ordinary looking person. So nobody would like to marry her. That is why she doesn't want to marry. And she says that until and unless the groom must be a foreign missionary. Foreign missionary means a religious person who travels to other countries. So until and unless a groom is a person who travels from countries to country, she won't marry anyone. Oh, there are a lot more cherry trees all in bloom. This island is the bloomiest place. I just love it already, and I am so glad I am going to live here. Okay. Then she says that the place had lots of cherry trees, and all the trees are in bloom. Bloom means they are full of flowers. Okay. In every cherry tree there are flowers, and all the flowers are in white. This island is the bloomiest place. And then she gives an adjective to this place, and she says that the place is the bloomiest. Bloomiest means there is no such word, bloomiest, okay? But here she used the adjective bloom here as a superlative, and she says bloomiest, okay? A word made up by Annie to mean having a lot of bloom. So she wanted to say that this place had the, there is no other place which carries so many flowers in it. Okay, so this is the bloomiest place on this island. I just love it already. and I'm so glad I'm going to live here. And then she says that she loves this place very much. Already she started loving this place and she's so lucky and she's so happy to think that she's going to live in here. She's going to live in this place. I have always heard that Prince Edward Island was the prettiest place in the world. I used to imagine I was living here, but I never really expected I would. It's delightful when your imaginations come true, isn't it? But those red roads are so funny. When we got into the train at Charlottetown and the red roads began to flash past, I asked Mrs. Spencer what made them red, and she said she didn't know, and for pity's sake not to ask her any more questions. She said I must have asked her 1,000 already. I suppose I had too, but how are you going to find out about things if you don't ask questions? And what does make the roads red? Now she is saying that she had always heard that Prince Edward Island, okay, that is the name of this island, okay, that was the prettiest place in the world, and she always imagined, she always dreamt of living in that place, and she had never thought that she would come to this place only. And she says that it is delightful. Delightful means it is so happy to think that when your imaginations come true, because she had already dreamed, she had already imagined to live in the Prince Edward Island. That is the name of the place. She had already dreamed. She had all the time, she had a dream that she should live in this place, and her dream came true. And then she is saying, but those red roads are so funny. Now she is talking about something else. She is talking about some red roads those roads were so funny, so interesting. And she says that where she had seen those roads. When they got into the train at Charlottetown, okay, so from where she came, she is coming from Charlottetown. That is the name of a town. And when the train started moving, she could see from the window of the train there were roads that were of red color. And she tried to ask Mrs. Spencer that how these roads are red color. Then Mrs. Spencer said that she doesn't know about it, and don't disturb her by asking so many questions. And she says that she had already asked so many questions. So she asked Mrs. Spencer that how these roads are in red color. And then Mrs. Spencer replied that she didn't know about this, that how the roads are in red color. And for pity's sake means to show some pity on Mrs. Spencer, and don't ask any questions from her. And she had already told that she had asked already 1,000 questions to Mrs. Spencer. That means as she got into the train, continuously she was talking and asking one or the other questions. So Mrs. Spencer had already told her not to ask any more question because she had already asked 1,000 questions before. Then she says, I suppose I had too, but how are you going to find out about things if you don't ask questions? And what does make the roads red? Then the girl says she would be so happy to ask 1,000 questions, but if you won't ask questions, how you are able to find the answers of that? It is the same thing as in the class also. When you get some doubt, you are asking. Until and unless you ask a question, you won't get it answer. So she is saying the same thing. Until and unless we are going to ask question, we are not going to get the answers for that. And then again, she is asking the question to Mr. Matthew, that what does make the roads red? Now she is asking to Mr. Matthew Cuthbert that how those roads were made in red color. Okay, for today we'll study till here only, and in the next class we'll continue from here. Okay, so your homework is read the lesson again, then you will understand it properly. Okay, read it again, and the words which you find difficult, underline it and get the meaning from the dictionary. And I will also tell the meaning, so you find the word meanings from the dictionary. Okay, so till then, keep learning, stay at home, and keep on learning all the question answers, whatever is given. Okay, take care, goodbye.